Now, there's a lot of things happening this year. There's the new GF100-200 is coming out soon, and I have pre-ordered one.
What did I say?
During the meanwhilest.
During the meanwhilest? No, no, not like that at all.
Oh, well, hello. It's an impoverished, well, now impoverished Dexter and me back on YouTube with another midweek video. And this evening's video, or whenever you're watching this, you could be watching this, I don't know, 3 a.m. or 2 p.m, I don't know, is a first impressions, first look and first impressions at my latest lens acquisition. Last week I bought a Fuji GF100-200mm lens. I know. For good reason though. My Fuji lens, or like my GF lens lineup at the moment, is short, should we say. It's the 23mm f4 and the 32-64mm kind of standard zoom, if you like. I didn't have anything longer than 64mm, which is around about 50mm in full frame equivalent field of view. And I'd always yearned after something a bit longer. Now, in the past, whenever I'd wanted to shoot telephoto images, I used the 55-200 on my X-T3, and I've been really happy with those, but there's always been a burning desire within me to get a longer lens for my GFX. Now, there's a lot of things happening this year. There's the new GFX100S is coming out soon, and I have pre-ordered one, but I don't think I'm gonna buy it. I gotta be honest, I'm so happy with my GFX50R, and I don't really think doubling the megapixel count is really gonna, you know, improve my photography then, put it that way. Might make the images look a little bit nicer, I don't know, but I don't think it's really gonna improve what I do as a photographer. I think as it is, the 51.2 megapixels on my GFX is overkill, to be honest, but there we go. I say I did pre-order it, but I'm not gonna buy one, so I'll be getting my £5 back. after making that decision, I thought, well, I'd buy this lens. I mean, a lens is gonna do a lot more for me than any new camera could. It's gonna give me a lot more opportunities to take different styles of landscape images. It's quite a capable portrait lens. Let me come on to that in a minute. But also later this year, Apple are rumoured to be bringing out a new iMac. And I was thinking, shall I get one of these, shall I not? And then somebody leaked them on YouTube. Oh, and they just look so nice. They look like the Pro XDR display had a relationship with an iPad Pro. But the thing that's really kind of swaying it for me is it's rumoured they're going to be available in several different colours, and it might be bye bye to this now 10-year-old design on this iMac. But we'll see. I mean, this computer is still more than good enough for what I needed to do, and I guess perhaps I'll buy another lens for the GFX. I don't know, we'll see. Anyway, on to the topic of today's video, and it is this absolute, oh god, behemoth, beast of a lens. It does look like I'm overcompensating for something, doesn't it? First impressions, can't fault it. I kind of knew where I was gonna get. I mean, it's the same build quality as my other two lenses, the 32-64 zoom in particular. The zoom ring is lovely and damped, and just, it's firm enough without being like over firm. You can still move it with, you know, one finger. Focus ring, again, really beautifully damped. Unfortunately, as is common with the other two lenses I've got, it's focused by wire, so there are no hard stops at its closest focus distance, which I don't know what that is, because it doesn't matter, because it's not very close. And an infinity. I'd love to have seen a hard stop on the lens, but there we go, it's not there. The aperture ring is really, really firm. You're not going to bump that. And it's got like a clutch mechanism then to go into the auto or into the C position, whereby you can use one of the command dials. The lens has got a tripod collar. I don't really think it needs one. It's not that heavy. It's not that much heavier than the 32-64. But it's got a tripod collar, which is handy. It's got marked data points on it for, you know, 90 degrees and top dead center, but no kind of like ratcheted stops. Then this will spin freely. There's no like lock at 90 degrees, which is unfortunate, but there we are. I doubt, to be honest, that I'll use it that often on this, because like I say, it's not that heavy, it's not overbalancing the camera, so I don't think it really needs a tripod foot. The hood is enormous, as you can see, and in common with the other GF lenses, it's got this clutch operated switch, so you can't just pull it off, you've got to press that in first and take it off. Lens has got 67mm filter threads, and there's an access door on the hood if you want to fit like a polarizer to go in there and twiddle that around to your heart's content. Trying to put this down now. Right, any problem with it being so large is it doesn't sit on my shelf very well and sticks out, so you have to be very careful that I don't actually bump into it. Right, image quality wise, well, I'm really hot for some reason, I don't know why. Image quality wise, it's excellent, it's typical Fuji goodness. At time of recording this, I've only taken a handful of images with it, and I'll pop those up now and talk you through them. By the time I get this video out in probably, I don't know, a week and a half time from now, hopefully I'll have been able to get out with the camera and the lens and take some proper landscape images. We'll see. We'll have to see what Mark Drakeford, our wonderful First Minister, says and allows us to do. But the images I shot one of Dexter, handheld. The two images I'm going to show you now were both handheld. The one of Dexter and the one of Lisa. Because I forgot to mention the lens does have optical image stabilization built in. There's a switch on the side of the lens for it, and there's also like a focus distance limiter switch as well. But I always tend to leave those on the full kind of focus range. The OIS seems really good. The picture of Dexter was shot, I think, at something like one. I'll just check. Yeah, 1/25th of a second at 126mm, handheld, and it's perfectly fine. The shot of Lisa was shot at 1/100th of a second, but perhaps the most telling shot is the one I'll pop up now. Well, this is like a screen recording of it, and it's of the view I shot from the back of my house. Now these trees are about a mile and a half away. Now I know this isn't a long telephoto lens by any manner of means, but this is a handheld shot at 200mm. The shutter speed was, I can't recall now, but it'll be on the screen. And it's pin sharp. It's really good. I mean, I cropped in again, and blown the image up to 300%, and it's fine. There really is, you know, you can't fault it. It's not a great photograph by any manner of means, but the detail in it is superb, and for that reason really I don't think I need the 100 megapixel GFX 100S. It's not going to give me any more than that can. So first impressions. Really, really happy with my purchase. Couldn't be happier. I've now got three GF lenses to cram into my camera bag, which is now creaking at the sides. No, I'm not going to buy a new camera bag. So I think now I've got the 23, the 32 to 64, the 100 to 200. I think I've got all bases covered. Now you may think that with the 100 to 200 being a constant f5.6 aperture, that it's going to be no good for things like portraits. The one I shot of Lisa and the one of Beth and Noah, the autofocus areas, the bokeh, seems fine to me. What you've got to remember is this is a medium format lens, so in terms of depth of field, f5.6 translates to something like f4.2, 4.3, something like that. But also, you can get closer to your subject with medium format lenses, so it's going to throw that background out of focus even more. And that's it really for this video now. What I'll do, as usual, is pop up some images shot with it at the end of this video, set to a little bit of music, as usual. So hopefully by the time this goes out, there'll be more than the two or three images that I shot already with it for you to have a good look at. Right. Thank you very much for watching. Even though I put my new do not disturb sign outside the door, there are still people talking outside my room. How very dare they? Right, that's it from Dexter and me for this week. We'll see you again on the weekend with another unmissable video. Take care.
Jockey in Hartlandburg, who works at WAND. He puts two or three eggs in him, then he's in your car by 6 a.m. He lives for his job and he accepts his pay. You can call and request lay, 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 lay. He'll play Stanley Jordan, U2 and Levine. He'll even play the band. College.